over some tips, tricks, and just little things that you could bring to your next practice session if you want to improve on this etude. Now, right from the get-go, looking at measure one, the tendency seeing all these articulate rhythms is going to be really peck and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But one of the things I recommend practicing is just recommend slurring it really slow. Next up, looking at measure 9, we're going to be talking about some flexibility. It's really hard to do this lip stir down, so one of the things I recommend practicing this, taking it out of context, and we're just going to be doing some lip bends down this C major arpeggio. For practicing this, you know, Brand Reinauer talks about with flexibility, not necessarily air or lips, but rather thinking of a vowel, thinking our lower vowels being ah, and as we go up e, so we're thinking, so the tongue just naturally comes up, so it's gonna be like ah. This is one of the kind of the reoccurring themes that occur a lot of times throughout this etude. Well, the best way I can recommend practicing this is, first of all, just slow it down. You know, take ego aside and just slow down the tempo, even the 50%. And if you're struggling with playing it really slow, something you can do in your daily practicing is just, when we do our typical card studies, we can do this similar articulation pattern. It's just slurring two over and over again. Now moving on to measure 37, this is kind of like that stands out from the rest of the etude. It's really low on the trumpet, it's really chromatic, and a couple ways to break it down. First of all, take it half tempo. Whatever you're doing on the metronome, cut it in half, 50%, and slur it. You can make a little game out of it and start at 50%. Do it three times in a row correct, bump up the tempo, three times in a row, bump it up, and so on and so forth. Second way I recommend practicing this is change up the rhythm. You know, it's really going to make you think about it. And the last part we're going to be looking at is measure 50. This is a really challenging part because it's a lot of tonguing and slurring that we're not necessarily used to. But something that we can apply to our Clark studies every single day if we just do tongue, slur to tongue. Those are all the tips and tricks I got for you today. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm planning on recording a lot more etudes, so stick around to this channel. You won't want to miss out. Thank you.